moment in my career of retiring with my daughter ready to move into a career at Duke, whatever it will be, because I don't know. And sitting back and watching what that's going to be like while I take care of one of the favorite people in my life, my grandboy, is something I couldn't have imagined. When I came to Duke, you were just starting college, I think, and thinking about a major. And right. So the whole idea of my sitting here talking to my daughter, a professor at Duke, when I think of you as choosing a major at Princeton, is just very nostalgic for me, yeah. You know.
In the 90s, when you first came to Duke, if you could tell me something about what you felt as you tried to form or find a community here.
That's a really interesting question, because what I remember in the 90s is feeling totally on display everywhere I went. Oh, that's the African-American woman who was hired. You know, there was no community. And certainly there were black professionals on campus, faculty and staff, but we were so few and far between that my appointment made news. And in that way, I often felt on display in a way that was really uncomfortable for me. So my first interest at Duke was to create, you know, what I call a company, congregation, other folk to be mixed up with.
So you wanted to find people to hide around.
Exactly, you know me. So exactly, I wanted company. It was hard to be private and to do your own work at Duke when people were looking to you to handle any black thing that happened, whether it was relevant to you or your work or not.
Do you think that it's changed? Is it no longer the case that any black faculty member will have to handle any black thing that happened?
How do you feel about that? Do you feel you're the perfect example of someone new to Duke, and whether or not you feel you can just relax into, well, I don't know if relax is a word, but move into your own work, or do you feel sort of responsible for the community?
That's an interesting question, because I think that there is a little bit of space to decide how I want to engage with different issues on campus at Duke. And I think it's very obvious where that space has come from. I know the generation of scholars before me, your generation of scholars who helped create that space and are still working to make that space.
It was an argument, because the idea that any black person at Duke should be responsible for anything that happens black at Duke was hard to sort of allow Duke to see us in more complex ways. But if you're feeling there's some space for that, that means we're working in the right direction. I agree with you. I don't think we're quite there yet. But the goal is to make it easy for you to make the selection of who you want to be at Duke, rather than whatever the politics of the moment are.
But when I think about the issues of diversity and inclusion in the sciences, the ones where I've been more engaged and more active in thinking about how to make Duke better, the good thing that I can see is that I have a community of people working with me from all across the spectrum of gender identity and gender and different ethnicities. There is...
You're talking about at Duke.
At Duke. Mm-hmm. At Duke. I think there is a broad-based effort. It's not everybody, but it's broad.
Yeah, I like that, and that means there's been some success.
What do you think is the most important bit of institutional knowledge that you would share with me or other faculty in my position?
That we never think large enough for ourselves, and if we ask for something or want something outside of the boundaries we set for ourselves, that's probably what we should be doing, because our boundaries are confined by what we think we know other people have or are doing, and we never know the large institutional picture. Having an outrageous ambition in terms of yourself and what Duke can do for you, you'll do for Duke. Aren't you getting people asking you to do and represent? So you will work for Duke, but the goal is to make Duke work for you. And that's so much more fun.
Great.
So I've learned that, I think. As you think about your future at Duke, the things that you can't imagine are probably going to be far more interesting than the things you do imagine for yourself. This, I could never have imagined. Wow. But I really think, okay, this worked out well.
You know. I think it did. Thanks, Mom.
You're welcome, daughter.